Don't let the badge fool you. The new compact Jaguar crossover is very much gasoline fueled. Confusion over the name clearly fooled a few launch attendees though. Pre-drive discussion focused on whether it would have sufficient battery endurance to get us the 60 miles to lunch in Brighton, an iconic seaside resort on England's southern coast. Such are the priorities of jet-lagged road testers, the relief palpable when it was realized good ol' internal combustion power means a range of over 400 miles by the quoted EPA combined figure. And our fish and chips wouldn't be going cold. The fully electric I-Pace will join the crossover lineup eventually, but for now the E-Pace is a more conventional junior partner to the F-Pace, the fastest selling vehicle Jaguar has ever built. Why wouldn't they want to capitalize on that with a smaller, more affordable but equally stylish second model line? With a $38,600 starting price, it's nearly $3,500 cheaper than the equivalent entry point to the F-Pace and Evoque ranges, but, as we'll see, with a character of its own. If the E-Pace looks like a slightly truncated F-Pace with some sharper body detailing and a sportier face, then little wonder. The basic lines are familiar, but it's 13.3 inches shorter overall and 7.6 inches less in wheelbase. It looks taller as a result, but is more or less identical to the F-Pace in height, with harder edges, reverse cuts in the flanks that catch the light, and a slinky trunk lid helping make it look lower and wider than it actually is. The major difference under the skin is the E-Pace's transverse engine layout. The basic foundation shared with the Evoque and distantly related to Forza's platform. This is a Washington's axe situation, though, as the fundamental layout and center floor pin are similar to the Evoque's, but the front subframe and rear suspension all new. The powertrain is more closely related, being based on Jaguar Land Rover's 2.0-liter Ingenium turbocharged gasoline engine and driving all four wheels through a 9-speed automatic transmission. There are two power options, 246 horsepower for the standard car and 296 horsepower for the R-Dynamic models. Also used on the Evoque, the active driveline system on R-Dynamic models is based around Jeep K&'s twinster rear axle unit, with full torque vectoring across the rear axle when engaged. And if this is suddenly ringing bells, that's because, yes, it's the same hardware corrupted by Ford to turn the Focus RS into an oversteering, drift mode enhanced hoonigan. Unlike Ford, Jaguar doesn't overspeed the rear axle to contrive that oversteering balance, though it was apparently considered early in development. Durability concerns and the fact that soccer moms are probably more interested in all-weather traction than going full can block put paid to that idea, but the power advantage over close rivals like the 228 horsepower BMW X1 xDrive 28i and 208 horsepower Mercedes GLA 250 mean Jaguar has the sportiest option in its class. The E-Pace's power makes itself felt in the first few miles of the test route. Jaguar could have played home advantaging routed us onto suitably smooth and flattering roads. Instead, we're straight onto the bumpy, concrete-surfaced orbital expressway that surrounds London before heading off along tight and twisty English lanes whose occasionally haphazard pavement is covered with a slippery carpet of wet leaves. Our test car is the more powerful model, more or less equivalent to the $53,100 MSRP or Dynamic HSE topping state-signed price lists. For a limited period, there's also a $53,550 first edition model with unique Caldera red paint and 20-inch wheels using the 246 horsepower motor. Jaguar has always loved big wheels, and the 20s on this car look good, but the thin sidewalls can't blunt the intrusion of expansion joints and potholes. Constantly variable dampers as part of the Active Dynamics package will be available in due course, but our test cars have passive struts, so below 30 miles per hour the E-Pace shows a brittle side. As the speeds increase, this diminishes and the brand's trademark body control comes to the fore. The integral link rear suspension is key here, variations of this setup used across the Jaguar and Land Rover ranges and designed to both improve wheel control and packaging, with less intrusion to trunk space than the Evoque setup. In the Jaguar style, The E-Pace feels as composed and stable in the middle of its damper stroke as it does when settled. This flowing character helped by well-weighted and positive steering.